Hey guys, I'm Caroline Chambers. I'm a recipe developer and the cookbook author of Just Married, a cookbook for newlyweds. I'm so excited to be helping Le Creuset launch their new white cookware with a gold knob. We are making a one pot cheddar, basil, and corn orzotto with shrimp. It's so simple. It is like the epitome of summertime cooking. Let's do it. First things first, we are going to do a really simple, easy, quick marinade on these shrimp. They don't get used until the very end of the recipe, so they'll have like 15, 20 minutes to marinate at room temperature while we're making our orzotto. Grating in some fresh garlic. This is one of my favorite kitchen tools. It's a microplane. If you don't have one, you can use just the smallest hole on a box grater to do this, but you do not need to clean this yet, because we're gonna use it again on our orzotto. Half teaspoon of salt, the zest of one lemon, and then don't forget to reserve this lemon because we're gonna put the juice into our orzotto and it just like brightens it up, cuts through all the cheesiness and just makes it like. I'm gonna toss everything with a tablespoon of olive oil from my gigantic olive oil. I really like to do this with my hands because then you don't end up with like one huge clump of garlic on one shrimp. Just get in there, make sure the garlic and the lemon zest are evenly distributed. Set this aside while we start our orzotto. Melt some butter right into here, 2 tablespoons. I just used a large shallot and minced it up. We're gonna saute it for like 2 to 3 minutes until it's soft. Stir in our orzo, 1 cup of orzo, because we just wanna toast it and get it like a little nutty. We're gonna grate in 2 more garlic cloves straight into here. Toast it until all of the orzo is kind of covered in butter. Starts to smell really incredible. About 30, 45 seconds. So it's starting to kind of stick to the bottom, which is really easy to see because of the white enamel surface. Very nice. It smells incredible, so I know it's time to add my stock. I'm using chicken stock. You could use vegetable stock, beef stock, fish stock, since we're cooking with shrimp, would be delicious. I just cranked up the heat. We're gonna bring this mixture to a boil over high heat. It will not take long to reach that boil, which is really nice for a simple recipe like this because the surface area of the braiser is so large. So it comes up to a boil much faster. Once it comes to a boil, give it a big stir. And we're gonna reduce this down to low and cover it until almost all of the liquid is absorbed, about like 8 to 10 minutes. We'll see. It's been 8 minutes. I'm gonna take a peek in my orzotto. See how a lot of that liquid has been absorbed. So we are going to stir in a few ingredients. A cup of fresh peas, but you could also use frozen. Kernels from 2 ears of corn. 1/2 teaspoon of salt is going in here. I love some red pepper flakes in mine, but if you're not a spice person, omit it. Give that a big stir. I'm gonna add about 1/4 cup of chicken stock because too much of mine got absorbed. And we want there to still be some liquid in there at this point because we're not finished yet. And these shrimp are going right over top. So you can kind of arrange them or you can just dump them, but we do want them in an even layer. If you're using a Dutch oven or a cast iron and you have a little less surface area than me, no big deal. You can overlap a tiny bit, but try to get them each their own space. I'm just gonna cover this and let it cook for 4 minutes. Let's check it out. It's been 4 minutes. Okay, so the guys in the middle are like perfectly cooked, awesome pink. The guys around the outside have a little bit of cooking to do, but that's okay, because they can do it. We're gonna keep the heat on low. Give this a big stir. We're adding in the juice of 1/2 of a lemon. This is the lemon that we zested earlier. 4 ounces of shredded white cheddar cheese. 1/4 cup of Pecorino Romano. You could also use Parmesan. Turn off our heat and then stir everything in. It smells so good in my kitchen. The garlic, the cheese, the lemon. Keep stirring until you don't see any flecks of cheese. I'm just gonna garnish with fresh basil leaves. So these big, beautiful leaves go right on top. I'm trying to impress people with a one pot meal. Just take a wet paper towel and wipe down the sides. And then you have a beautiful pot turned serving dish. Why would you ever transfer this to a serving dish when you have something this beautiful? Those are hot. Glad I touched them. All right, so I cut up the other half of that lemon into wedges, and I'm just gonna place them around so that people can grab one and squeeze fresh lemon on top. Freshly ground black pepper, a little bit more pecorino or Parmesan, depending on what you used. Less than 30 minutes from start to finish. That is summertime entertaining at its finest. If you're bringing this out to the table, everyone's not quite seated yet, ready to eat, just throw the lid on top, keep all that heat in, and eat when you're ready. Enjoy.